Hi, so yeah, I'm Nicola from A1 Tan, and this is the lovely first coat, looking fantastic. I've been tanning for the, it is sitting perfect. I've been tanning for the Ukdfba now for, oh God, I think it's about 12, 13 years. I also tan for quite a lot of other federations as well, the IBFA as well. And we also run our own IBFA A1 Classic every August, which is just obviously amazing. I do tanning services from my house as well in Leicester, and that's obviously an independent tanner for any show. I actually had someone there this morning for a PCA show, and that was at 7 o'clock this morning. So I tanned this morning before I came here. It's good. You know what, if people want the best tan, and then they will travel, so it's good.
Yes, awesome. Honestly, it just sits on the skin like so well, as you can see. Like, this is the first tan, and it's soaking in already. And it's, like, obviously we know I'm pale.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. And I don't have to touch you. I just leave it, I soak in. Normally then I'm tanning three or four of the tents, come back to you, and it's ready, it's done. About 15 minutes, no fans. We don't need any fans. We don't need you getting freezing. You know, you're on time for your appointment. We always give you an appointment. You're on time for your appointment because you know then you need to eat, you need to sit down, maybe go for a wee.
Yeah.
You want to turn up to the tanning team, straight in the tent, 15 minutes, you're out of the tent. That's the way we do it.
Make sure you exfoliate and take care of your skin prior. I moisturised, I've exfoliated, I've done the job. Now it's time to let this.
You can tell, you've got perfect skin.
There we go. How are we doing, YouTube? We are back yet again. Okay, so the big show. Another big show, another British final. This is an international championship for en route to Budapest later in the month. So we'll be literally doing this show. Got another show next week, and then potentially we're doing a show the week after. So that could be three shows, 3 weeks. Fingers crossed if all goes well. Big stage, black backdrop, looks wicked. Ukdfba, so excited. Everything's gone to plan. Last couple of days, we carved up, started on Wednesday, had a deep tissue massage done Thursday, linear carb loaded yet again. Last night was awesome. It's Olympia weekend, but more importantly for my journey, it is UKDFBA international weekend. So yeah, it's awesome. So fingers crossed we can get the job done today. I've had a speak with coach. He says that I'm on, the look is looking really good. I've already got the first coat of tan all done. And next step is just basically getting the feet up, watching guys and gals on the stage, and then we'll be on ourselves. All right, guys, so we are just sitting here watching the show before we go on. Just getting ready, feet up, as you can see. Just posted this wacky update. And look who's just dropped me a message. I mean, second place, classic physique. If it wasn't for Sebum, this guy would have won it. Mike Summerfield. People are calling me Mike, Mini Mike. I mean, a la badass. It's coming. But yeah, Mike, honestly, massive inspiration. It's crazy. The fact that these guys at such a high level can like sort of acknowledge your hard work definitely means a lot. It's so good for motivation. But yeah, it is time to get the next coat of tan on in a minute. And then we're going to play it by ear, see what coach is saying. We're getting meals in. And then we should catch you on the stage.
Come on, James.
Gentlemen, take a quarter turn to your right.
Right.
side, James.
James.
Jamesy baby.
But ladies and gents, these titles are only worth winning if the opposition is strong. And tonight the opposition was strong. So let's give it up for Tyler Lloyd.
Oh my gosh, guys, we did it. Like, I wish that I'd had a victory speech, but I really wasn't expecting it. Say that I nearly broke down in tears just then because of the amount of hard work that people don't see behind the scenes, the day-to-day effort, just the, you know, every hour. Like, I can't put it into words. Like, you can't miss a meal, you can't miss your cardio, you can't miss your steps, you can't miss like the grams on your diet of what you're eating. It all adds together for moments like these. And like, if there's anyone watching these videos that's starting out in bodybuilding, or you know, it's like one of them ones where you're considering doing it or not, just go and do it. You know, if you want to do it, do it. You've got one life, so why not? You know, if you're gonna do it properly. I'd say that at least. But in terms of what we've done today, I would never have imagined. I came here sort of thinking it's going to be an absolute stacked class, and we're really deep into the season. To say that I'm battered is like an understatement. But just to compete against the level of these guys is incredible. But to actually come out and win an international show, yeah, Tom's whole lot proud. Like, thank you to Coach Keithy West. You know, absolutely turned it around for me mentally as well. I was in a bit of a downward spiral, but after one of the shows, we just pulled it back, and so much support from family. I wish I could word this better, but I just can't. I don't know what to say. So I'm so thankful for those around me. The support system just, you know, you can't do this by your own. As much as it is a solo sport, you just can't do it by yourself. So, yeah, I'm so thankful for everyone around me. They add up to moments like these. So, thank you guys. Let's go and see what the family's saying.
Oh my gosh. Gold. Gold.
Gold. It finally makes it to the cupboard.
First of the UK season and finish of the UK season.
And gold. This?
I know. Wow, feel how heavy that is.
You're going to let me loose with it.
Yeah, this is why this is why I put so much effort in some moments like these. Oh. It's just, yeah.
Just in my little muscle.
It just means so much more when you've had moments where it's been a bit up and down. Do you know what I mean, this year?
It's well worth the effort.
Only you've really seen how bad it's been.
Told you it'd be worth it today. Dunno.
Oh, fuck no.
Come on.
Yeah, it's been tough. It's been tough.
Go on, let it.
No, it's just, oh.
It's worth it. Look at it. Look at it. See what it looks like when somebody else has it. But it's yours now.
It's just been so much hard work, and then I know anyone's going to be happy with like second a few times, which obviously I am, but you know when you just miss it a tiny bit, and now finally just, and it's a massive show as well. Oh.
Okay, it's yours, you hold it.
Good. Yeah.
Okay, gents, listen in. This is for all the glory. Please, walk a turn to your room. Walk a turn to the right. Gentlemen, face the rear. One leg back. Double bicep. That's it.
Let's go, James.
Keep going, James.
Back spread. Gentlemen, side triceps pose, either side. Face front, abs and thigh. And your best, most muscle up. Okay, gentlemen, relax. Thank you, Chris. The judges are rendering their votes. Okay, gentlemen, please relax. Take a step to the side of the stage, onto the side of the stage. Four in their division. And it must be an omen because 147 is the perfect scoring snooker as well. Ladies and gentlemen, your overall champion for 2024 is Jordan Long!
How are we doing, guys? Okay, so we have just got off of stage from the overalls, and what a battle it was. Just missing out on the overall, unfortunately. That would have been a hell of a nice trophy. But in terms of putting stuff into words today, that would definitely come for the end of season review that we'll do. I've got two shows left, which are two in Europe, so that's going to be... That's going to be awesome to do that. Experiences are going to be made. I'll try and get whatever content I can. Just want to be present in the moment with them ones. But as of for now, yeah, UK international champion for Ukdfba. Unreal. Really, really tough class today. And we came out with a dub. So over the moon's an understatement. And yeah, unreal experience over here at Ukdfba. Really well run show, went all smoothly, backdrop was awesome, just the black standard backdrop. And in terms of staff, everyone smashed it. You've got the judges, everyone organising it, and Nicola, who's in charge of A1. So now it is time to just chill with the family, de-stress, feet up, have a chicken and rice meal, which is like coconut themed, which is going to be banging. And then I've got an oat bowl which has got like blueberries and apples and stuff in it. So I'm just going to enjoy tonight, soak it all in, get my content out on Instagram, TikTok, you name it, in the morning or tonight, depending on how we're feeling. It's quite an early-ish night for a show finish, to be honest. But yeah, wow. Thank you to Aaron behind the camera as well. So that's what I've got to say. I'm probably going to look back on this and think you could have worded it better, but we're living in the moment, and that is the way to do it. So